It's time now for Police on the Scene with a Crime Prevention Lean, with your host, police officer and national crime prevention professional, J.D. Dhein.
Hey, this is Officer J.D. Dhein. Welcome to Police on the Scene. You know, tax season's coming up, and with that, another scam is out there that you need to be aware of. IRS agents, not real ones, but people that say they are automated calls claiming that they're IRS agents are calling people about tax issues. And I want to just kind of share something with you really quickly. Things people need to know is that consumer hotlines throughout the United States, especially with the Department of Agriculture, Trade and Customer Protection, is basically lighting up with questions about fraudulent telephone calls. Thankfully, most of the consumers out there are just letting them know that they've been attempted to be scammed. Recently, there's been a real spike in calls regarding fake Internal Revenue Service, IRS phone calls, both live and robocalls. In this scam, and it's nationwide, a caller falsely claims to be a representative from the IRS and warns that the call recipient that they are behind on taxes and must make immediate payment to avoid arrest or legal actions. After threatening victims with jail time, deportation, or driver's license revocation, scammers may hang up and call a second time claiming to be the local police or DMV, which means Motor Vehicle Department. Caller ID information is usually spoofed or not right or wrong or just completely fake. The IRS basically has a few things that they want to tell you about, and this is very important. Number one is the IRS never asks taxpayers to pay their tax bill using prepaid debit cards. The scammers are trying to get your card information so they can use it fraudulently. The IRS contacts a customer about unpaid taxes. They do not by postal mail and not by phone. And do not be fooled if your caller ID does say IRS or the agency's toll-free number. Again, these scammers can run programs that can make any number or any name come up on your caller ID. Scammers may be able to recite the last four digits of a victim's social security number, and they can do this by other online information sites. And scammers sometimes even send bogus IRS emails to the victims. Again, instead of a phone call, it's an email to try to con you out of your credit card information or your money. So if you receive any of these calls, hang up, do not press any buttons. And if you would like, you can also, for additional information, or let the Customer Protection Bureau know about your call, or if you have questions about it, you can call their hotline at 1-800-422-7128. When people are calling you up trying to get personal information or get money from you and you did not solicit the call, hang up and your money will stay in your pocket. With that said, I'm Officer J.D. Dhein. Stay safe, and I'm 10-8.